Okay, everybody, so I'm coming to you today to share a couple of things with you, which is going to be this makeup look, and it is an inspired look, and also I wanted to show you all my hair. So, I think I look like a damn boy, like a little boy or something, I don't know. So, if I keep playing with this ass, I'm just, I don't know. I haven't taken my hair through so many changes, but I will share that with you after I tell you about my makeup look. Now, everybody's been doing this look, the inspired Nicki Minaj, Bees in a Trap makeup look. So, I have to give credit to her because it's her original look, but who actually inspired me was Pink Sugar Spice, because she did a video on the look, and she just did the damn thing in her video. So she inspired me to do a look. Also, I had just commented on her video and told her that I needed to, I was going to try that look on. So here it is. See the, yeah, she looked so cute in that video. And she just really, that was like one of the best videos I've seen as far as the Bees in a Trap makeup inspired look. So, yeah, so you inspired me, Diva. So this is what I came up with. I have to put like my own little twist on it. So, it's inspired, so it's not going to look exactly like hers or anybody else's. Okay, y'all, so let me show y'all what I use. Now, I used the Jumbo Pencil, the LA Color Jumbo Pencil in Seashell, and I took an angled liner brush, and I just kind of drew out the shape that I wanted, and I filled that in, and then I used these Amuse Matte Eyeshadows, and the first one I use is this Green Leaf, and it's this green color. And I put that like on half of my lid, and then I use this Ocean Blue here, and these two are matte eyeshadows, and I put the Ocean Blue right in the middle on top of the green, and then I went to this Wet n Wild baked eyeshadow palette, and I figured the name of this one because Miss Rosby sent me this. I tore the package off. And it doesn't have it on the back, so yeah, but I took this blue right here and I just put it at the end where the wing out part is, right in the corner, and then I followed the same steps under my eye, so the same colors are under there. And I also lined the top and bottom of my eyes with the Eyes Lip & Face Cream Eyeliner in black. And then I went over it with the top part with the liquid liner, Eyes Lip & Face liquid liner in black. And then I have the Beauty Supply Store, you know, just the regular Beauty Supply Store eyelashes. And I have the number 99. I didn't do a dramatic one because I actually want to wear this look out today, and I'm not really going anywhere that calls for dramatic lashes. So, yeah, I'm not going there. So, maybe next time. And what I have on my lips is the Nika K lipsticks, and I have two different kinds that I blended together, and I use the Pink Tint. Which is, this is a new one that I just got. I don't know, I've just been into pinks lately. So that's the Pink Tint. And it's like a Barbie pink, and it's kind of lighter than what I have on now. But I mixed this Brilliant Fuchsia, and I probably should have just put Beach Fuchsia on. I probably would have got the same color that I have on now. But yeah. That's the Brilliant Fuchsia, and I just put that in the middle and blended it out. And this is what I got. And then I went into my the 10 blush palette, and I use this pink here and put that on my cheeks. And then over top of my cheeks on my cheekbone up here, right up under my eye, I use this Radiance, Eyes Lip and Face Radiance Enhancer. And this one is in Sunshine. And just kind of has a little brush on it. And let me see if I can show you the product. It's creamy. And it's just like you smear it in and it just gives you like a glow wherever you want to glow at. You see? So it's like a highlighter. So I did use that. So, and this is my look. So I hope you guys like it. And definitely thumbs up the video if you would like to see a tutorial on it. And you want me to show you how I did the look, then I definitely will. Just thumbs up the video, and depending on how many thumbs ups or comments of people that ask me to do a tutorial on it, then I definitely will put one out. So, let me tell you guys about my hair. I've been putting my poor hair, my poor hair through so many changes. I just don't know what to do with it, so. Yeah, last year, probably about the last 8 months of last year, I didn't perm my hair or anything. I was just asphyxiated on going natural, and yeah, I'm seeing everybody go natural. I'm just going to go natural and cut all my permings off. I mean, I was really planning to go natural. And my hair was just growing so good, which I don't have a problem with my hair growing. But yeah, it was growing good. I cut all the permanents off, and I think November of last year, I cut all the permanents off, so it was just natural. So in January, I permed it. I was like, nah, I can't do it. It had been 10 months on 11 months. And I had permed my hair, and I was like, I was just getting frustrated with it. So I broke out, and I permed it, y'all. So then I wind up in February, like, I think it was like 2 weeks before my birthday, I wind up cutting it, like, this short. All over, it was just like this short, like a Holly Berry shortcut. So, yeah, so now it's long back. So, yeah, so this is the result of it going back. I'm perm my hair like every between 6 and 8 weeks, like doing touch-ups. And I just wash it with Organic Roots olive oil shampoo and then the leave-in conditioner. And I'll do like a hot oil treatment, olive oil hot oil treatment, like once a month. And then when I wrap my hair, I take like the natural shea butter and I kind of just moisturize it through and wrap my hair at night, put a stocking cap on it, even when I'm putting my wigs on, because I still wear my wigs. And I really haven't worn my hair. I just perm it, wrap it, and put a stocking on it. I clip my ends once a month, and yeah, so I'll just show y'all every so often to see how it's growing, but it was like this short, like where my hand is, it was like that short, so it definitely is growing, it was like that short all the way around, so, I mean, I don't know what made me, I just chopped it off. So, yeah, I'm about to weave it. I'm about to sew a weave in here. So, yeah, I'll stay tuned for that. And I don't know if I'm going to do it on camera or not. So, yeah, I don't even know. Yeah, but I definitely will. Maybe I get up here and after I put the weave in and everything in. Show y'all how I style it, or I don't know, but yeah, y'all, thanks for watching, and I'm just blabbing right now, so I don't know what the hell I'm going to do with this head. I look like a damn little boy right now, I know that. My sister said I look super damn young. So I look super, super young. Y'all let me know what y'all think. Okay, guys, talk to y'all later. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you guys later.
Sycamore.
Now every club promoter wanna bid like auctions, cause we pack shows, sell ticks like Boston. You see me in the lobby taking pics and flossing. After every pick, gotta fix my corset. I am running this shit, I am so exhausted. Batter up bitches, but approach with caution. You be talking slick and honestly, I can see why. You don't know me and I ain't talking about T.I. Just when they thought I was done for the winner, I came out stunting, I'm such a big spinner. I tour everything, but nope, I'm not a Gemini. My life's a movie, take me to the cinema. Take me out to the ball game, cause you know I only with ballers, yep, them is my type of niggas, shot callers. I've been around the world, I'm such a bad, bad girl. I got the Austin power flow, I'm groovy, bitches. And nope, you're no match for my Uzi, bitches. I dumb my raps down so I don't lose these bitches. Say some sex shit like wetter than jacuzzi, bitches.
In the world.